But when the Philistines heard that they had anointed David king over Israel, all the Philistines came up to seek David. And David heard of it and went down to the hold.
And when the Philistines heard that David was anointed king over all Israel, all the Philistines went up to seek David. And David heard of it and went out against them. And of the Gadites there separated themselves unto David into the hold to the wilderness, men of might and men of war fit for the battle, that could handle shield and buckler, whose faces were like the faces of lions, and were as swift as the roes upon the mountains. Ezer the first, Obadiah the second, Eliab the third, Mishmanah the fourth, Jeremiah the fifth, Attai the sixth, Eliel the seventh, Johanan the eighth, Elzabad the ninth, Jeremiah the tenth, Macbenai the 11th. These were the sons of Gad, captains of the host. One of the least was over 100, and the greatest over 1,000. These are they that went over Jordan in the first month, when it had overflown all his banks. And they put to flight all them of the valleys, both toward the east and toward the west.
The Philistines also came and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim.
And the Philistines came and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim.
And 3 of the 30 chief went down, and came to David in the harvest time unto the cave of Adullam. And the troop of the Philistines pitched in the valley of Rephaim. And David was then in an hold, and the garrison of the Philistines was then in Bethlehem. And David longed and said,
Oh, that one would give me drink of the water of the well of Bethlehem, which is by the gate.
And the 3 mighty men brake through the host of the Philistines, and drew water out of the well of Bethlehem that was by the gate, and took it, and brought it to David. Nevertheless, he would not drink thereof, but poured it out unto the Lord. And he said,
Be it far from me, O Lord, that I should do this. Is not this the blood of the men that went in jeopardy of their lives?
Therefore he would not drink it. These things did these 3 mighty men.
Now 3 of the 30 captains went down to the rock to David into the cave of Adullam, and the host of the Philistines encamped in the valley of Rephaim. And David was then in the hold, and the Philistines' garrison was then at Bethlehem. And David longed and said,
Oh, that one would give me drink of the water of the well of Bethlehem that is at the gate.
And the 3 brake through the host of the Philistines, and drew water out of the well of Bethlehem that was by the gate, and took it, and brought it to David. But David would not drink of it, but poured it out to the Lord, and said,
My God forbid it me that I should do this thing. Shall I drink the blood of these men that have put their lives in jeopardy? For with the jeopardy of their lives they brought it.
Therefore he would not drink it. These things did these 3 mightiest.
And David inquired of the Lord, saying,
Shall I go up to the Philistines? Wilt thou deliver them into mine hand?
Go up, for I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into thine hand.
And David came to Baal Perazim, and David smote them there, and said,
The Lord hath broken forth upon mine enemies before me as the breach of waters.
Therefore he called the name of that place Baal Perazim. And there they left their images, and David and his men burned them.
And David inquired of God, saying,
Shall I go up against the Philistines? And wilt thou deliver them into mine hand?
Go up, for I will deliver them into thine hand.
So they came to Baal Perazim, and David smote them there. Then David said,
God hath broken in upon mine enemies by mine hand like the breaking forth of waters.
Therefore they called the name of that place Baal Perazim. And when they had left their gods there, David gave a commandment, and they were burned with fire.
And the Philistines came up yet again and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. And when David inquired of the Lord, he said,
Thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass behind them, and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. And let it be, when thou hearest the sound of a going in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then thou shalt bestir thyself. For then shall the Lord go out before thee to smite the host of the Philistines.
And David did so as the Lord had commanded him, and smote the Philistines from Geba until thou come to Gaza.
And the Philistines yet again spread themselves abroad in the valley. Therefore David inquired again of God, and God said unto him,
Go not up after them, turn away from them, and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. And it shall be, when thou shalt hear a sound of going in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then thou shalt go out to battle. For God is gone forth before thee to smite the host of the Philistines.
David therefore did as God commanded him, and they smote the host of the Philistines from Gibeon even to Gaza. And the fame of David went out into all the lands, and the Lord brought the fear of him upon all nations. And David consulted with the captains of thousands and hundreds, and with every leader. And David said unto all the congregation of Israel,
If it seem good unto you, and that it be of the Lord our God, let us send abroad unto our brethren everywhere that are left in all the land of Israel, and with them also to the priests and Levites which are in their cities and suburbs, that they may gather themselves unto us. And let us bring again the ark of our God to us, for we inquired not at it in the days of Saul.
And all the congregation said that they would do so, for the thing was right in the eyes of all the people.
O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down-sitting and mine uprising. Thou understandest my thought afar off. Thou compassest my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. Thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. I take the wings of the morning, and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea. Even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, Surely the darkness shall cover me, even the night shall be light about me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee. For thou hast possessed my reins, thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. My substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret, and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Thine eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect, and in thy book all my members were written, which in continuance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God! How great is the sum of them! If I should count them, they are more in number than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, ye bloody men, for they speak against thee wickedly, and thine enemies take thy name in vain. Do not I hate them, O Lord, that hate thee, and am not I grieved with those that rise up against thee? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them mine enemies. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me, and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.
Again David gathered together all the chosen men of Israel, 30,000. And David arose and went with all the people that were with him from Baali of Judah, to bring up from thence the Ark of God, whose name is called by the name of the Lord of hosts that dwelleth between the cherubims.
So David gathered all Israel together, from Shehor of Egypt, even unto the entering of Hemath, to bring the Ark of God from Kirjath-Jearim. And David went up, and all Israel, to Baala, that is, to Kirjath-Jearim, which belongeth to Judah, to bring up thence the Ark of God the Lord, that dwelleth between the cherubims, whose name is called on it.
And they set the Ark of God upon a new cart, and brought it out of the house of Abinadab that was in Gibeah. And Uzzah and Ahio, the sons of Abinadab, drave the new cart. And they brought it out of the house of Abinadab, which was at Gibeah, accompanying the Ark of God. And Ahio went before the Ark. And David and all the house of Israel played before the Lord on all manner of instruments made of fir wood, even on harps, and on psalteries, and on timbrels, and on cornets, and on cymbals.
And they carried the Ark of God in a new cart out of the house of Abinadab, and Uzzah and Ahio drave the cart. And David and all Israel played before God with all their might, and with singing, and with harps, and with psalteries, and with timbrels, and with cymbals, and with trumpets.
Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and our fathers have told us. We will not hide them from their children, showing to the generation to come the praises of the Lord, and his strength and his wonderful works that he hath done. For he established a testimony in Jacob, and appointed a law in Israel, which he commanded our fathers, that they should make them known to their children, that the generation to come might know them, even the children which should be born, who should arise and declare them to their children, that they might set their hope in God, and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments, and might not be as their fathers, a stubborn and rebellious generation, a generation that set not their heart aright, and whose spirit was not steadfast with God. The children of Ephraim, being armed and carrying bows, turned back in the day of battle. They kept not the covenant of God, and refused to walk in his law, and forgat his works, and his wonders that he had showed them. Moreover, he refused the tabernacle of Joseph, and chose not the tribe of Ephraim, but chose the tribe of Judah, the Mount Zion which he loved. And he built his sanctuary like high palaces, like the earth which he hath established forever. He chose David also his servant, and took him from the sheepfolds. From following the ewes, great with young, he brought him to feed Jacob his people, and Israel his inheritance. So he fed them according to the integrity of his heart, and guided them by the skillfulness of his hand.